Welcome to Marrakesh, 47. The situation grows more tense by the minute. The consulate is under lockdown, but the protests are only a stone throw away from full-blown riots, and Zaidan won't hesitate to unleash his troops. So whatever you're planning, time is of the essence. Good luck, 47.
Please, forgive me.
Hello, come in. I'm sorry.
How's your father?
Doing well, thanks for asking. He's upstairs right now working on this novel of his, some kind of political thriller, I think. You know, airport lit.
Oh, that's nice. So he doesn't miss the old school?
Well, he was headmaster for 30 years. He still carries around the master key. You know, the one that fits all the locks? Doesn't seem to be able to part with the damn thing. But that's nostalgia for you.
Well, maybe now he'll be a famous writer.
The old headmaster of the school Zaidan is using as his field HQ lives right above the carpet shop. According to his son, he kept the school's master key out of nostalgia. Supposedly, this opens any lock in the building.
Yep, up, up and away.
Someone else will, but I'll make sure of that. Hey, I was just kidding.
Strandberg is a lunatic.
Hey. No, he is Captain.
I am so honored by your visit to my humble stall. Let me show something.
Oh.
Come on, be a gentleman.
What should we do? If Crystal Dawn get involved, should we take action?
No.
Citizen, how Orwellian of you.
Sir, are you suggesting that I'm representative?
Forgot to leave the all-access keycard in the parking garage.
You kidding?
I need to get back there before XO tears me a new one.
All right, I'll hold down the fort. Take the tunnel. It's way faster.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you. Huh.
At ease, recruit.
What the?
No problem. Salute, soldier.
General Zayden keeps coming down here to check on the prisoner. I hear they were close, so what'd he do, poor bastard?
The way I heard it, his brother was one of the policemen who got killed in the first attacks when he was prison transport this room. So he, got cold feet. Tried to blow the lid on the whole operation.
Not smart.
According to the soldiers, the condemned prisoner in the cell was a close friend of Zaydan. However, when his brother, a Marrakesh police officer, was killed during Strandberg's breakout, the prisoner decided to betray Zaydan and go public. Alas, he was caught before he could thwart the coup d'etat.
Huh.
Don't mind me.
You're in. Good work, 47. Now to locate General Zaydan.
So what did he do?
Prisoner. Never you mind. General Zaydan says the man's a traitor, and that's all he does. We got cold feet about the operation. Tried to rat us out.
Still on guard duty, huh?
Yep.
Hey.
I mean, sure, Zaydan does date some beautiful women. I'll give him that. He sure seemed to flock around them.
That is General Reza Zaydan, Keeper of the Peace.
Flag.
Oh, you're preaching to the choir, man.
Thank you.
Take point.
No problem.
I tell ya, I don't care what anyone says. That Zayden's nothing.
What? Might have a possible disturbance. Keep it posted. Hello? Hello? Nothing to worry about.
Hey, you there?
Huh? Yeah, you.
Seriously, though. Do you believe for a second?
You.
Hey.
I will be forced to take action.
Stop right there.
What anyone says, that Zayden's not all he's cracked up to be.
You're dismissed. General Zayden's orders.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
You're dismissed. General Satan's order.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Raquel. She'll kill him. She'll find out that he's been cheating on her and stab him in his sleep. And I'll be there watching.
Zaydan won't expect resistance from a tied-up prisoner.
Time to decide. What should I do? Well, don't tell me you're sleeping, Zayd. Plenty of time.
Target down. Move on to Klaus Strand.
Present arms.
So, Wanda, I think that Dr. Schlossberg would consider this a number four conversation. And you remember that Dr. Schlossberg
making a general one HP.
Don't believe everything you hear. Next thing you know, they'll have them at the grassy knoll.
Wouldn't that be something?
Strandberg has agreed to an exclusive interview with celebrity GNN reporter Pam Kingsley, no doubt to enrage the public even further. This could be a way inside the lockdown consulate, and the replacement cameraman, a local freelancer, is yet to arrive.
Tired.
Yeah, I need to see an invite.
Officer?
Sorry, don't mind. Oh, you know, have a look around. Yeah. Hello, hi, well.
Oh, what?
Go ahead.
Oh, sorry, my fault. No, I sent her a mail, and a text, and she's not replying. What's wrong with her? I told her to meet us and no word. I think she just go. Or something phone. Or eat somewhere we can never eat. Do you think we just do something?
You know, I like these cocktails. They're so good.
Well, it's just an idea.
Okay, yeah, I'm all for it. But let's just, get this.
Invite, please.
There should be room for all here, man. And
I want to be a great guy.
Hello, officer.
I am a great guy.
Officer? Snail soup! Snail soup! Soft and warm and well cooked!
5 minutes, I'll pack this all up.
Salute you, sir. Okay, let's all right.
Socioeconomic progress that rejects the failed political dogmas of the 21st century. If there is a
Thanks for coming so quickly. We never expected something like this. Not them, did we?
You made it. Most impressive, 47. Now to locate Klaus Strandberg.
It is not fair.
It isn't. You can't keep me in here under these circumstances. If I had known... Well, that's easy for you to say. You're not the one supposed to be doing deep tissue massage in a freaking war zone, okay? It is that bad, Donald, it is. Believe me. Yeah, no,
Mr. Engstrom.
Connie Engstrom, monsieur. Here for an appointment with Klaus Strandberg.
Oh, Mr. Engstrom. Please proceed to the massage room. It's upstairs on the right. I'll inform Mr. Strandberg.
Klaus Strandberg, go to the massage room. Your session awaits. I repeat, Klaus Strandberg. Please go to the massage room.
Whoa, buddy. I need to search you. If you're carrying anything inappropriate, this might be the time to say so. That's fine. Have a nice day, sir.
Ah, so the man with the golden touch. Let's get started. Shall we? Ah, oh, this muscle tension is killing me.
Why don't you lie down, Mr. Strandberg?
Oh, please. Call me Klaus.
Well done, 47. I will leave Strandberg in your capable hands.
That's the ticket. I tell you, nothing makes you tense like thousands of people wanting to kill you.
Both targets down. Now head towards an exit.
Jeez.
Nah, he wouldn't do that. I hear he's on a strict protein diet.
Okay, you know what? I've heard enough.
compromised. But I don't understand. There is no sign of forced entry, no alarms, nothing.
One of my people has gone missing in Johannesburg. A key bearer.
I wish I'd been informed. Still, the system demands two keys, and the rest are all accounted for.
Except for your late predecessors.
Comp? But his plane went down over the Pacific. It was an accident.
Such was the conclusion at the time. Yes. People die, Mr. Fannin. Happens all the time, even to us. It seems like a conspiracy. Probably isn't. And yet, the failed coup in Morocco, the ether virus, someone knows about us. There was a pattern and I failed to see it. Providence is under attack.
How much was there?
Money? Not money, Mr. Fannin. Information on all of our assets and operatives. Like you. Dig a trench, Director. And make it a deep one. Because none of you are safe anymore.